So we have a guest speaker tonight, Danielle. So thanks, Danielle, for coming. She is a one-time elite coach, a one-time premier. She is a six-star diamond and a Success Club 10 legend. So those are awesome accomplishments. And she's going to chat a lot about different things tonight. A little bit about diamond, a little bit about your back office, a little bit about vision. So a lot of good things. So Danielle, I will let you take it away.
Oh my gosh, let's just dive on in. What's up, you guys? Crushing it already to kick off this week. So excited to chat with you tonight, and it's good to see some familiar faces. What's up, Shelby? tonight I'm really going to be talking about the importance of diamond and the fact that it's so much more than just literally a shiny object. So we're really going to dive into the why, not just behind diamond, but other milestones within this business as you create momentum and gain traction and what that looks like. And then also get into some tactical stuff that you guys can actually implement. I saw some of you mentioning that you're going to hop on a power hour later tonight, so you can actually utilize some of these things that I'm going to share with you. And then I'll wrap with some final tips. But before I share my screen, I do have some slides. Just a little bit of background about me. So I have been in this business over 5 years now, and health and fitness has always been a big part of my life. I grew up playing soccer. I played through college. And then I got my first like big girl job working in corporate finance, right? So that was like the first time in my entire life that I wasn't surrounded by a community of women. Right? That sisterhood, that team who has my back, we work towards common goals together, like all the ups and all the downs. But I was like, okay, well, you know, I'm an adult now and this is what I'm supposed to be doing according to societal norms. So I started working in finance, went through a leadership development program, got my MBA part-time at night because I was like, well, why not? My company's paying for it. And I finally came up for air after I graduated from my program and then my MBA. And I kind of looked at myself in the mirror and I was like, is this really what I want for the rest of my life? Like, am I truly fulfilled? Am I truly passionate about this? And I just had that like, that itch for more. I'm sure some of you guys can relate. And hey, if you're sitting where you're at right now and you love what you do, then even better. But I just knew that I needed something to change. And that's really why I even gave these programs a shot. Like, I was that girl that was going to the gym over an hour a day, like all the cardio. I was on the treadmills, just doing whatever the heck I felt like, Stairmaster, a class here and there, maybe some abs, like, you know. And I just felt like I was kind of plateaued in my fitness journey as well. So I was like, I'll just try these programs, see what they're like, you know, see if they actually work. I was convinced that they were not going to work. And I did the 20-minute fix. It blew me away. And I was like, this could be a thing, you know? So I ended up like enrolling with my hairdresser. I really did not have like my upline, like had a team page that I was in, but they were just all at a different point in their life. So I really struggled in the beginning because I didn't really relate or resonate with kind of their, you know, their training style and the things that they were having us do as like new coaches. So I kind of paved my own way, and took the initiative to go out on YouTube and in the back office and all those corny trainings with Michael Neiman. And, you know, I just want to share that with you guys because I think it's good perspective for you to have. Number one, that you're in a position right now with some absolutely incredible leaders and clearly an incredible community. So don't ever take that for granted because I know what the other side of that looks like. And I think also it just shows the power of if you make a decision and you're fully committed and this is your plan A and you're going to do whatever it takes to make it work, you're going to make it work. But you need to make that decision and have that belief before anything else is going to happen. And I always knew, I was like, this is something that I want to gain traction with and see where I can take this. And you guys, I started with zero social media experience. I mean, I had a business background, so that was helpful to some degree, but you know, like all of this was foreign to me. I didn't like the idea of selling. Like, so I had a lot of limiting beliefs and hurdles, mental hurdles to get over, but that's the beauty of this business, right? The fact that essentially our job is our journey. And I forget where I heard this, but essentially this business opportunity is like a personal development growth journey wrapped up in a business opportunity. So I think the fact that like, that's literally what we do, it's not hard. It's just a matter of like, are you willing to push through your own BS to come out on the other side? And that's literally something you're going to do forever until the end of time, you know? And what a gift that is, that that's literally the only way we're going to see success in this business is to fill our cups and focus on ourselves. So just wanted to kind of paint that picture of kind of, you know, my coach story and where I came from. I don't actually coach full-time now. I also work part-time for a company headquartered out in California. I'm a client manager. It's their go live. And we help clients go live. So I do a lot of like the new business stuff, but my hours are flexible. So I kind of wake up, do my coaching work, and then focus on my go live stuff in the middle of the day. And then I catch back up with my coaching stuff. So I'm sure, raise your hand if you do not coach full time. Sure. It's nearly all of you. Yeah. So, you know, I definitely understand the juggle. But I also think there's a lot of power in the fact that like our schedule's a little tighter. So what does that mean? We need to be a lot more intentional with our time, right? Okay. So enough of the boring stuff. Let me dive into the meaty stuff of this call. Can I share? Yes, I can. Perfect. Okay, guys. So the goal of tonight's call, we can see my screen. We're good. Yeah. Okay. Is I really want you to just get excited about diamond and even what's next. If you're sitting there and you're a diamond right now, maybe you're a star diamond, you know, whether you're a brand new coach or you're a leader on the team, this is going to be valuable for you in some form or fashion. Okay. And also, you know, make sure you leave this call feeling empowered to really take that next step in your business. Like I remember when I started coaching, I put diamond up on a pedestal and I thought it was this like big, crazy thing. And that's one of the reasons why I think, you know, I wouldn't say it took me long to hit. I hit my first 3 months, but I literally, you guys, was diamond for like 2 years. It was terrible. I was in and out of diamond. And I think, you know, of course I start my journey through coaching was a little bit different than most. But I think it's really important to make sure that you know that it's not diamond is just a part of the journey to really kickstart your business. And the only way you're going to be motivated and feel empowered to hit diamond, for instance, is understanding why you want to hit it. Because I hear all the time, oh yeah, I want to pop diamond. And I ask, you know, my coaches, well, why? And they're like, well, because that's what we're supposed to do. There's nothing that's like deep seated behind it. That's really, you know, forcing someone, creating necessity to show up, to get up early. You're not going to wake up at 4:30 in the morning because you're trying to hit success club or you're trying to push for diamond. You're going to wake up at 4:35, whatever time in the morning to work on your business because you have that bigger vision and dream. And that is what's going to move you forward. Okay. And I also want to remind you that there's no secret formula. It's very, very simple. We're going to go through it all tonight and you're much closer than you guys think. I also remember in the beginning of my coaching journey, I was like, I'd watch all the top coaches and I convinced myself that they knew something that I didn't. I'm like, there must be some sort of like app or invite or this or that, that they know that I don't. And I got to figure it out. It's like, no, Danielle, you just need to do the work, right? And 10x your efforts. So just a little reminder for you guys. And I love this quote. It's from the book Relentless. If you have not read the book Relentless, I highly recommend it. It's the trainer for Kobe Bryant, Michael Jordan, Tim Grover. It's like tough love, no BS book, quick read too. But he says, pressure can bust pipes, but it can also make diamonds. And that's literally the difference between our mindset and our belief. Okay, so we're going to do a little activity here, but kind of elaborating a little bit more in terms of connecting your goals in this business, whether it's diamond or it's something else, to your why. And you guys have heard this numerous times, but I just want to revisit it tonight, at, you know, before we go through some of the tactical stuff. As I mentioned, diamond is essentially just a milestone. It's a business metric, okay? And that's all it is. And it's a stepping stone towards those big dreams of yours. So when you think about this business, the foundation of being successful, it starts with your mind. Okay. So if you're not pouring into PD every single day, change that tonight. Okay. We need to believe in ourselves. That's the only way we're going to get to that next step and accomplish our goals. And then what happens next? That trickles into our habits, right? So do we really think that we can hit diamond by a certain day? Do we really think that we can accomplish whatever that goal is that we have within the next, you know, whether it's the next month or 2 months or 3 months? Assuming that we do, and we have that belief, right? And we're filling our cup and fueling our mindset, then our habits need to be aligned to that every single day, right? And that's going to filter into your goals as you start to accomplish those goals. And then over time, you're going to eventually accomplish those big dreams. And that's the gift of this business. I mean, you can make your life, you know, come to fruition, whatever you want, but you need to understand that it literally starts with, and if for some reason you're not seeing success right now, it's probably because you're just getting in your own way. But the good news is that you have the power to change that. So real quick in the chat, I want you guys to, and I'm going to play some music. I want you to comment and share your 5-year dream. What does your life look like? How do you feel? What do you see? And where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? Okay, so let's utilize the chat. I'm gonna play some jams, give it like a minute or two, and then we'll dive back in.
Step out. You pray till the lights come on, and then you feel like you've just been born. Here you come to raise me up, but I'm bleeding and broken up. Now we're back in the arms of love. And I think it just died. We're together.
Guys, some more time to continue to pop your dreams in the chat, but I don't know about you, I'm literally like smiling from ear to ear over here reading through all of these. It's absolutely incredible. I mean, you know, spending time with your future kids, or you know, the kids that you have now, financial freedom, freedom of time, paying off debt, being a full-time coach. Oh gosh. And you know what the coolest thing, you guys, about this, at least in my mind, is knowing that you're all doing this together. We're doing this together. You know, you're not just off on your own trying to run your own business. Like, we not only get to build a life by design, but we get to do it alongside of a kick-ass community and team who also dreams big and hustles and gets stuff done. Like, you know, a rising tide lifts all boats, and that's literally where you guys are sitting right now, okay? So get excited, and please always keep your why, there's a reason why, on our business activity tracker. That's the first thing you see at the top, you know, like, what is your why? Who is your target market? Who is your niche? So we are constantly staying rooted in the reason why we're showing up. If you're seeing yourself being a little inconsistent right now with your coaching journey, it's likely because your why isn't strong enough, or you need that refresher every single day. So write it down, create a vision board, record it, play it in the morning when you're listening to your or when you're going through your morning routine, whatever you need to do, what's going to resonate with you and be that constant reminder. It's so unbelievably critical to see success in this business and create that initial momentum and to keep it going moving forward. Okay. So thank you guys for being vulnerable and sharing that. I'm going to pop my slides back open. Let's see here. Okay. So I'm going to just quickly cruise through the slide because it's nothing you haven't seen before, but obviously as a part of tonight, I do want to make sure we all understand the what. I'm sure there's a few new coaches on here. So essentially, and this just is a visual representation of how simple it is to hit diamond. Okay. It's literally 12 coaches, and you can see, I mean, I would highly recommend, and I say this to all of my girls, print this out, make it physically exist, and fill in those dang bubbles, okay? Put dates next to them. Understand, you know, who you currently have enrolled, who is active, who is inactive, you know, do you have a controlled account? Do you have a working coach? Are you working with them to lock in Emerald? Like, being a business owner and really understanding your current landscape and also understanding the gap between where you're, you know, at right now and where you want to be, so that you can take the actions and have the habits every single day to get you there, to fill that gap. That's what it, that when we talk about being a business owner, right, and taking ownership and initiative and being proactive, that's what this means, right? So just please remember that it is very simple. It's only going to be hard if that's the story we're telling ourselves, all right? So print this out if you have not printed it out already, or if you have a prettier version. I've had this for years, so it just works for us. But I think having it physically exist in a place that you see it every single day is very, very powerful. Okay, guys? All right, so the why. Obviously, as I have mentioned, diamonds really, in my mind, where your business really starts. I mean, Emerald is amazing because you get that initial win as a new coach. Obviously, you'll be celebrated, and you'll start to open up the ability to earn residual income and get free leads and paid leads. But diamonds, like, really where we're moving and grooving, right? We are at a point where, you know, we're really understanding that we're capable of doing, you know, we're capable of accomplishing everything that we're setting out to do. And initially, yeah, maybe diamond does seem like it's something that's like crazy and oh my gosh, it's so far away. But literally, like, I remember when my first diamond, who's now one of my very best friends in that picture, she hit and she was like, I made this such a big deal in my head. And now I'm literally like, why isn't everyone diamond? And I was like, praise, like, it's just crazy how much we can get in our head. And it's literally like you against you. So just some perspective there. But I just thought that was so funny. I'll never forget Sam saying that to me. But it's really cool because, you know, you're recognized as that leader within your team and also at a company level. It also earned you a spot at the team retreats. And honestly, for me, like, if I can get some sort of like gear or gift and go on a trip with my girls, like, I'll do whatever I need to do. I know, you know, with COVID and stuff right now, trips are, we're hopefully you know, on the tail end of it. But at the same time, it's really exciting to look forward to, like, finally all getting together and being like, look at how far we have come in the past 2 years, right? It's just going to make it that much sweeter. And, you know, I think when you're in this environment with your team, you get to know them more personally. And, you know, this business is fun because we can, you know, really create our own success and work alongside of some incredible, inspiring, driven, hardworking women. But guess what? It's even more fun when you get to call those women your friends, right? It boosts your confidence when you lock in diamond, and obviously attraction marketing. The fact that even if you're not going on a retreat right now, or going to in-person events, the fact that you can show up and you can, you know, on social media, have that confidence and that conviction of like, I'm doing the thing. Like, that is the best feeling when you have a goal and you wake up and work every single day and align your actions with obviously what you need to do to accomplish that goal. And then you hit it and you're like, I did it. I can do anything. What's next? It like feeds on each other, right? It's those daily deposits that add up. And eventually you look back and you're like, I created that mountain because I showed up every single day. Okay. And obviously, you know, once you hit diamond, you are just one step closer to one star and two star. So in my mind, diamond is a stepping stone. One star obviously is incredible because that means that your team is evolving with your own leaders. You get to go to the new leader conference, which is absolutely amazing. And that also means you're one step closer to two star, which is really where you're going to see a lot more momentum from an income perspective. You're going to get to open up your second business center. We always say like, oh, I wish I could just have someone like me who really like wants to hustle and work this business. Well, guess what? When you lock in two star, that's exactly what you get to do. Open up another your second CBC. Okay. So this is where we're going to get into like the nitty gritty of the how. Okay. And I just want to take you through this process because, and for the leaders listening, this is going to be a good refresher of always staying in phase one of your business, right? No matter where you are at, this is the foundation of what's going to make you successful. Okay. So, and I say, how can I forget, I heard this on a leadership call recently. But the how can I concept is every single day when you wake up, ask yourself, how can I accomplish XYZ? What is your main goal right now for the next 12 weeks? Love the 12 week year too. And how can you get one step closer today to that goal? What do you need to focus on? What are the 2 to 3 activities that are going to drive your business forward? Because you're going to focus on how you can accomplish that specific goal. If we are trying to do all of the things all of the time, guys, it's not going to work. And it's also going to make you crazy because you're going to feel like you're in a million different directions and constantly busy and doing things, but you're not doing the right things. Okay. So there's a difference between being busy and working on your business and being intentional with your working hours and intentional about your goals and asking yourself every day, how can I get one step closer to accomplishing whatever that main goal is of yours? Okay. So I say fill your buckets, okay? Because these are buckets that feed off of each other. But if you're a newer coach listening to this, like obviously the first thing that we need to do here is post our going public post. That's what we call it. But it's like announcing that you're a coach, you're so excited, so that, you know, when you're sharing on social, people actually know what the heck is going on. But you probably have heard this before. Your job is your journey, right? So I'm going to keep saying that. So committing to a program and getting results is the name of the game in this business. We're health and wellness coaches, right? Fitness needs to be the foundation and nutrition needs to be the foundation of everything that we do. So if you don't have results to show for that, like none of this matters. That needs to be your number one priority, okay? And then sharing, obviously, your workout clips and your lifestyle, emphasis on your lifestyle, on your posts and your, or on your stories and your feed daily. If you're a newer coach, I know it may seem intimidating to think about posting every single day, but you have more to prove. You know, like people need to see you. The more they're going to see you, the more they're going to get to know you, the more they're going to love you and trust you. Okay. So there's that imbalance at the beginning and I'm not going to sugarcoat it. You know, like it takes some energy and some hustle and some hard work to really, you know, pump that well and eventually start to see all that hard work come to fruition. But guess what? While you're pumping your well, what are you doing? You're falling in love with your journey. You're filling your cup. You're becoming a better, you know, a better you. And that in itself should not ever be anything that we take for granted, right? So I want to also share that, like, because I have coaches who right now are pushing for diamond and they'll post on their stories every single day, but they're not posting nearly enough. Okay. So when you think about your stories, obviously that's great because that shows the behind the scenes. But the same eyes are typically watching your stories. If you want new eyes and more followers, right? And you don't need a ton of followers to be successful in this business. I'm just going to say that, but you always need new eyes looking at your stuff. You're going to do that through posts. So if you're posting once a week, once every 2 weeks, I mean, if you're a newer coach and you're posting, you know, 3 times a week, and again, you know, you do what you do with what's within your bandwidth. But if you really want to create a lot of success, post as much as possible, you guys. Like, spend Sunday creating a content calendar for the week and understanding what you're going to post and when, and maybe, you know, batch work a few posts so you're not scrambling after a long, crazy day at work. I have been there, saying, oh my gosh, I need to get a post up, and you're tired, and you're just, it's the last thing you want to do, right? That's going to show through in what you're saying and your energy. So plan ahead, be a business owner, you know, batch work, be intentional with your time, and make sure you're planning out your marketing calendar and your posts for the week. Okay. And I also really want to share number 4, the importance of obviously talking on your stories, showing your face, but sharing what you're doing and why you're here. Not just the what, like, oh, this is my workout and this is my shake and, oh, I'm on my team call tonight. Like, okay, that's great. But why? What's the why behind that? And really putting pen to paper, just like we did with our big dreams, on what your fitness story is. Like, for me, I used to be a former athlete, right? I missed that sense of community and that team, but I was also just plateaued at the gym, and I was, quite frankly, I was bored. And I was clearly uneducated because I just did a bunch of cardio because I thought that's what was going to create the most results. And I was wrong. And I've learned that over the last 5 years coaching. But, you know, now it's the structure and the convenience of these programs and the community. And just knowing that every single day when I show up, like, I know exactly what workout I'm going to be doing. I don't need to drive to the gym. And I feel confident because it's building upon each other. I'm not just, you know, throwing a dart at the dartboard and seeing where it lands. And that's the workout I'm going to do. So making sure you understand your fitness story. Maybe you didn't used to like working out. Like, I could work out all day. Nutrition's where I struggle, so I talk about that. But like, my success partner, she used to hate working out, and she's like this big nutrition guru. So she talks a lot about that. And guess who she relates to? Those people who also, you know, struggle with working out. And they see what she has done through these programs, and because she's sharing her journey. And what does that do? It gives them the confidence that they're going to be in good hands when they join. So the story behind it, you guys, is so important. I think it was Angie Belmar on a call recently. She said, you know, we can show up and share our workout clips and share our shake like a performing monkey, but anyone can do that. You know what I mean? So you really need to make sure that, again, you guys, you're staying rooted in that why. Okay. And then, you know, inviting your warm market, I think, as a newer coach, this is like the name of the game, at least how I gained a lot of my initial traction with my business. And it was helpful too, because a lot of my friends, you know, were former athletes and kind of floating around and in a similar place to where I was. But your warm market is your besties, your family, your friends, people who know you and trust you. So if you can get those initial wins and start to, you know, feel your best and focus on your own journey, have a few friends join you. And I'm going to share some scripts too with you guys. You know, that's going to give you all about those initial wins that will compound over time. Because alongside of that, what are you going to do? Number 6, you're going to get your name out there. Okay. You're going to build connections with your cold market in parallel to everything else you're doing from 1 to 5. So I'm not going to do a deep dive into my connection process, but you guys understand that. I mean, and I'm not sure exactly how you have, you know, how you, are taught, but it's really shifted, at least from my perspective, to blasting out a bunch of invites to genuinely connecting with people and getting to know them, and then potentially bridging that gap, right? And I'll share some examples with you. But that's also what helps with retention. That's also, yeah, it's going to be a little more time consuming, but it makes it more fun. You're getting to know people, on a deeper level, right? I mean, that goes a really, really long way, especially, you know, in the world that we're living in now. People want to feel that sense of connection and they don't want to feel like they're just being sold. And, you know, how many times do you guys get messages? I get at least one or two a day of people just popping into my inbox. I've never talked to them before. And they, you know, they're clearly trying. I'm like, okay, well, what do they want? What do they want? Nope. Like, so, you know, I want to remind you the importance of connections and, you know, the fact that it makes this business more fun. And then obviously, like I said, sending those invites from the conversations that you have going, and then you're a new coach, right? You post your going public post, you commit to your program, you're doing all these things behind the scenes. When you're done, and I don't care if you're a new coach or not, sharing that transformation photo, people need social proof. And personally, like every time I'm like, ugh, it's been a little bit since I've shared a transformation photo. I probably should share one. Like I'm being vulnerable with you guys. Like I don't necessarily enjoy it because in my mind, there's so much more to my transformation than what you're seeing physically. Right. But that doesn't mean that we need to pop up a post and just talk about physical changes. Like talk about the mental shifts, talk about the confidence, talk about everything that you're doing and how, yeah, like you're starting to feel better physically, but the icing on the cake, the best part is that, you know, you're really starting to believe in yourself. You're keeping the promises that you're making to yourself. You're feeling more confident. You're feeling stronger. You're feeling a sense of purpose because you're a part of this incredible community of women who have your back, who cheer you on, who hype you up, you know, create that FOMO. Who wouldn't at least like have their curiosity piqued when they read something like that? So do a quick little like gut check and see when was the last time you posted a transformation photo, and make sure that if it wasn't within the last 4 weeks, that you get that on your radar this week. Okay. Okay. So let's dive into some examples. So I talk about the warm market invites, the cold market invites, and then the transformation photo. And please, like these are literally just examples that I whipped up, what I would personally say. So make them your own, you know, talk to who you're talking to on social as if you're talking to them in real life, make sure it's your voice. But for your warm market, you can say, girl, so I just started these new workouts and I'm doing them with a bunch of other girls through an online sweat studio. It's actually been so fun. And the workouts are kick ass. You need to jump in and do this with me ASAP. Like, that's literally what I would say to my friend. Like, I wouldn't be like, have you ever considered it? I'd be like, dude, like you need to do this. You're going to love it. I love it. Like, let's go. So, you know, don't overthink it. I think once we, at least for me, like when I was a newer coach, it was like, I all of a sudden was overthinking everything. And then like someone would ask me for more information and it was like word vomit central, but like take a step back, take a breather, stay in control of the conversation, act as if you're talking to someone in real life, right? And, you know, that's, I think, a great example of how you can reach out to one of your friends or, you know, someone close to you. And then a cold market invite, I have two here, but you could say something like, hey, Megan, okay, so not sure if you'd be into this or not, but from our conversations that we've already had, I feel like you'd love slash be so much fun to have in my sweat studio. Would be fun to work out together too. Winky face, is that something you'd be interested in doing with me, right? And then another one is, yo, okay. So at this point, I'm sure you've seen that I host online sweat studios and preach about how much I love these workouts. Not sure if fitness is your jam or not, but I think you'd be awesome to have in the group with us. Okay. So, you know, those are two examples that you could send to women that you're already having conversations with. I think a lot of times my coaches will ask the question, it's like, well, I can go out and make connections and comment and respond to stories and do this and do that. But like, how do I bring up, you know, the fact that I want them to join me? Like, don't think of it like that. Just think of it as you're connecting with all these people. You're creating that big bucket of new potential friends of yours. And if it feels right and you genuinely think that they'd be a good fit, then send something like this. You know what I mean? And a lot of times, if you're showing up consistently and doing your job and sharing stories and posts, like, and you're talking to them, they're going to see those posts. And likely, it's going to naturally come up anyway, or they're going to ask you about it. So it's not weird. You know, remember, I think sometimes we can get in our heads about invites and how it's coming across. But at the end of the day, like if we're keeping this opportunity stuck inside our mouths, it's almost, and I like tell myself this when I get in my head, it's me being selfish because I have seen how much this has changed my life why wouldn't I want to shout that from the rooftops? And that's why you need to stay in phase one, your job is your journey, because if you aren't excited about your results and what you're doing and how you're feeling, you're not going to want to send invites. You're not even going to want to show up, right? So that's why that has to always be that foundation, and not just, you know, your fitness journey, but your belief and your mindset, that brain fitness. And then transformation photo, like you share your transformation photo. And this is just one example with actually an invite on the end, but sometimes I'll send these types of messages with just like, you know, no invite at all. Just like, hey, thanks so much. Appreciate the love. But you could say, thanks for the love on my transformation post. So kind of going through who's liking your transformation photo. Once you post it, once you kick ass in your program, you are the best. Not sure if you're on a fitness journey or if working out is your jam, but I would love to work out with you if that's ever something that you'd want to do. So, you know, if it makes sense, you can send that. Otherwise, you can just thank someone and start that conversation, and who knows what it's going to lead to. But we can't go into conversations like having an ulterior motive in the back of our heads. We need to show up and serve and fall in love with our journey, and you guys, the rest is going to follow, right? All right. So hopefully these were helpful for you. And then some final tips to wrap, because I do want to leave some time at the end just for some questions and Q&A and conversation. But obviously, you saw the Diamond Roadmap. It's literally just 12 people. 12 people. I mean, think about, you're hitting Success Club. That's just 3 people every single month. If you're hitting at least Success Club, if not more, every single month, you should be Diamond in 4 months. So that's why, you know, Success Club is just another metric to make sure we're constantly gaining traction in our business and actually doing our jobs and helping people, new people every single month. That new blood, you know, that's how I feel like I constantly stay excited about this business. And of course, working really closely with my team and focusing on my own journey. But having those women who come in and they're like, oh my gosh, like it's only been a week and I'm already loving this. Like I'm feeling amazing. Like, thank you so much. I can't believe it took me this long. Those messages go so far. And that's why it's so important to constantly have new people coming in. But unless you're filling those buckets, you're not going to see that, right? They all feed off of each other. And then when you think about Diamond, in my mind, like once you hit for the first time, I'm just going to sit here and say that it's going to be very rare that you have a solid diamond of 12 working coaches. Like if that's you, then, you know, power to you. But typically once you lock in diamond, like you're building from a controlled account. Maybe you're building from, and I'm going to talk about discount coaches too at the end. That's okay, guys. Get that initial win and continue to build. Get that momentum, get that confidence, boost it up, and utilize that to drive you forward. So when I think about Diamond, controlled account, build that to Emerald. You need one working, technically, at least one working coach, unless you want two controlled accounts. Help that person hit Emerald, build your controlled account to Emerald. The rest could just be discount coaches or friends who want the discount on Shakeology. Okay. And I'm not going to show my coach office or anything for just because of time, but you know, I also want to remind you guys to be a business owner. If you don't understand what preferred placement is, we're placing either on our left leg or our right leg. It's a binary business. So that's why you see those two legs with the Diamond Roadmap. You need to make sure that that's something that you're always aware of when you're enrolling your coaches and your discount coaches. And then also your sponsorship drill down. I just recently, one of my, Sam actually, one of my top leaders, best friends, she just locked in 3-star. And one of her diamonds who was holding through qual just had a new emerald pop. And long story short, I found out that she didn't know how to access her sponsorship drill down. And I'm like, how the heck did you go through qual without knowing that this was a thing? Like I'm literally in my sponsorship drill down like at least once or twice a day. Okay. So again, I'm not going to dive into like how to get to that, where to find it, but just make sure if you guys are sitting there and you're like, oh, I'm not sure what that is. Totally fine. Just ask your coach, like take that initiative and be a student and learn. And then this is a little blurb of what I share in my share cart email, which I wanted to share with you guys. Okay. And this will change once they roll out the preferred customer program, but I enroll most of my bootcampers as discount coaches. And this is what I will say. So da 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 da. But at the very end, I don't ask them about, oh, do you want the VIP membership or just want to be a regular customer? I just make the executive decision for them. And I put this little blurb at the bottom of my share a cart email. I say, no, I enroll everyone with a coach discount. So if you want to continue incorporating the superfoods or the pre and the post workout, depends what package they enroll with, I'll change that, into your routine, you'll automatically get a 25% discount moving forward. And if not, you can easily cancel and you're not locked into anything above and beyond this initial package. And if I get pushback or if someone's asking me a question about the business service fee, I'll just explain it. And sometimes there will be girls who are like, yeah, I don't really want to put my social in. It doesn't happen too often. And then I just send a new email over with the as a customer. So it's not a big deal. But when people see like, oh, okay, well, this is how she enrolls everyone, they're not going to second guess it. And like when I'm enrolling with controlled accounts too, like honestly, sometimes I don't even say anything and they don't even notice that it says like Brad Tanton or Sharon DeBernardo, you know, my mom. So don't overthink it. And if someone does have a question, just answer the question. Like if someone asks me like, oh, how come it says Sharon DeBernardo as my coach? I'll just be like, oh, no worries. Like, that's my mom. I manage her account. I'm obviously your coach. So as soon as you're done with your enrollment, just let me know and I'll send over your welcome email. Right? So something quick and easy. And sometimes I do give them the heads up, like, hey, just as a heads up, you might see that it's going to say Sharon DeBernardo, whatever, is your coach. But not to worry. I am your coach. And da 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 da. So that is all I've got. I'm going to end with a quote. Love quotes. Having a long-term goal provides a catalyst for motivation at every waking moment. Having that deeply rooted why that's going to get your booty out of bed in the morning, and it's going to have you, you know, focusing on your business activity tracker, showing up for your workouts the days that they're hard. Like that's what we need as humans to accomplish our goals. So do a gut check, you know, and do a deep dive into where you want to see yourself in the next 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, and understand what you need to do to bridge the gap again between where you're at now and what you need to do to get there. So I'm going to stop now and I guess open it up for some questions.
I have a question. In terms of like recruiting coaches, like what is your, like, I don't want to say invite process, but like, are you seeing more like joining from like clients to coaches, like existing challengers, or is it more like, what's your process through that?
Great question. I've always been big recruiting my coaches out of my boot camps. It's just, it's a part of that process. Now, you know, that doesn't mean that I have not enrolled someone who is starting just freshly as a coach. I had two girls last month in that boat, but in my mind, it's just a lot for someone to come in and wrap their head around. Like, I mean, committing to these programs, to joining this online community in a bootcamp, that's enough in itself, right? And then adding coaching on top of that, you know, and some people can do it. I would just much rather, because I have seen coaches come in hard and fast and they're like, I'm going to do all the things. And then they burn themselves out and then they ghost me. Like, so I would much rather someone focus on their own journey, fall in love with these programs, fall in love with the products, you know, fall in love with the community, and then have that natural progression to like, I want to pay this forward. It's just like any product, you know, anything that we use, like obviously if we like it and it's serving us, we want to tell other people about it. So yeah, most of my working coaches and my top coaches are from my bootcamp. And that's why, I mean, we could have a whole separate call on the importance of running bomb-ass bootcamps, but I really pour into it. I spend a lot of time in there. Yeah. Any other questions?
I have a question.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, thanks for everything, like so many great tips. But I just want to ask you, like, what would your advice be for, like, say a new coach who feels discouraged because they're like doing all the things and they're getting a lot of no's, which I know is normal, but like a lot are feeling discouraged right now. So I just want to know what your advice would be.
I'm getting plenty of no's too. We are in this together, right? That's just a part of this business. I'm sure you've heard like go for no. In my mind, you know, people that are saying no, it's not right now, you guys. And especially as a new coach, like I have been there, it gets exhausting and you're like, I feel like I'm putting so much work in and I'm not seeing traction. And it's like, well, what's even the point? Like, so trust me, like, cause I said, I have been there. But that's why we have to stay rooted in our why and rooted in our journey. And instead of focusing on things that aren't necessarily going right, or focus on everything that's going right versus what's going wrong, right? So I think so often we, maybe 10% of what we're doing isn't going our way, and we're focusing on that 10% versus like, okay, no, like I'm in a place right now where physically I feel the most fit I have in years. I have an incredible community. Like I'm building a brand on social media. I'm getting comfortable sharing and putting myself out there. Like all of those are such big wins. So don't discount all the accomplishments that you already have, and know that everyone that's saying no, they're looking at you now through a different lens. So they're now watching you. And this is, again, it circles back to why we have to stay consistent. They want to make sure that if they're going to join you, you're not going anywhere. So if all of a sudden you're like, you know, you do your going public post and you post here and there for a few days and then you're MIA for 2 weeks, like that's the worst thing that you can do. Talk about like this business being an escalator. You know, you're going up the escalator, and if you take a few steps back, like you have to start from the beginning. So continue to just build that momentum for yourself, and stay focused on everything that you are doing, and do not compare yourself to other new coaches on the team. Like maybe you're hitting Success Club, maybe you're not, but that doesn't mean you're less than. Yeah, maybe it means there's an opportunity for more growth or more invites, but maybe you're not at a point in your life like where you can dedicate as much time as some other coaches are. There's nothing wrong with that. So again, I know it can be hard sometimes, but that's the name of the game in this business. And the more you fall in love with your journey, the easier it's also going to be to combat those objections. And instead of someone saying, oh no, you know, I just don't think right now is the time. Well, okay, why? You know, like if you don't mind me asking, like what's your biggest hesitation? What's your concern? That's an opportunity for you to get to know someone better and for them to know you really care, instead of just being like, okay, no worries, you know? And it also builds your follow-up list for the next month. So that was a long-winded answer, but again, could probably have a whole call on overcoming objections. Yep, just have to keep going.
And I think too, to remember, like, how many times did we say no before we joined? Like, it took some of us a long time, right? So remember that too. But I love that answer. Does anyone else have questions? Any new coaches or anyone? I feel like somebody has to have a question. I feel like Andrea Reith has a question in her.
It doesn't have to be about Diamond either. I mean, you guys can ask me anything. I'm an open book.
No?
Oh, I had to leave for a second, but how many invites are you sending every day? I don't know if you already answered that when I left.
I haven't answered that yet. I don't have a set number for myself. I really focus on filling those buckets and like pouring into my connections and having really good conversations. So I would say per day, I would say at least like 5 invites, but I'm not counting them. As long as I'm having genuine conversations and I'm showing up, I know that that's creating the traction that I need to, you know, accomplish what I'm looking to accomplish.
I have a question.
Yeah.
So this might be like a silly question, but for your connections, like, what does your connection look like? Like, I'm sure it's not just like, I love your shirt.
It depends. Yeah. So honestly, connections are my absolute favorite. So I will go to like a random boutique, a local boutique, local coffee shop, a yoga studio. We live near the wineries and I love drinking wine. So sometimes I'll look at the wineries and I'll see who's, you know, liking those photos, who's commenting on those photos, who's active, who's tagged in photos at those places. And it doesn't need to be local, but personally, I'm like, well, why wouldn't I try to attract a local team, right? And then I'll click on their profile. If they have a story up, I love responding to their stories. Like, even if it's just a little hard eyes, like, we don't need to be like, I love your shirt. Because then it's like, well, what the heck does this person want? You know what I mean? Like, sometimes it makes sense. Like, if I see someone, sometimes I'll go to, like, where we went on our honeymoon, LeBlanc, and see who's, like, tagged there. And depending on, you know, the situation, if their profile is public or not, like, sometimes we'll be like, oh, my gosh, I see you were just at LeBlanc. Like, we went there. I'll send them a message. we went there on our honeymoon, our absolute favorite resort ever. It looked like you had a blast or something like that. So it depends on what I'm seeing. If they have stories up, that's even better. Sometimes it's just a matter of like liking two photos. Like you don't want to like a whole bunch and be weird. And then commenting on one just so they like, they see you. It's like, they know that you're watching and you're there. So, you know, and think about like, if you just spent, think about how many connections that you could make if you just spent like 30 minutes doing just that. And every single day that building and compounding, like you want your inbox to be exploding. That's when you know you're doing your job. You're doing all the work you need to do. Does that help, Andrea?
Yeah, for sure. So you mostly like focus on connections rather than invites.
Yeah. Because okay. For me, the connections authentically lead to the invites. Awesome. I'll go on my stories. I'll see who's watching my stories. And that's kind of where like sometimes if I'm like, oh, I'm a little behind on my invites. Like I'll send invites for my stories. Because honestly, a lot of times, like when I click who's watching them, I've already had a conversation with these people. I've already sent them a follow-up. I've already maybe sent them an invite. It wasn't the right time. So it's a good opportunity to be like, hey, I'm still here. I still see you watching me. You know, you ready to do this? I think we have a few more questions here. Okay, so Jessica said, what's the best thing to post when starting as a new coach? Like, what did you guys start to post about? So number one, you're going public post, but then you want to think about what makes you you. Like, are you a new mama? Are you a fiance? Are you a new homeowner? Do you love, can you work from anywhere? You know, I love White Claw. That's a part of my brand. You know, like little things like that go a long way. Are you a dog mama? So thinking about like, we always say, what are your five? And obviously coaching is a part of that, but that's really what you want to focus on, you know? And that's why I talked about also having a marketing plan. Like for me, the very beginning of my month, the first 2 weeks, I focus a lot more on the boot camps because I start a new boot camp every single month. So I'm talking more about the fitness. And then I always host a coach info session mid-month. So then like last week, I really shifted to talking more about coaching and sharing those types of stories, sprinkling that into my brand. I'm continuing to do that. And then towards the end of the month is when I kind of pivot and start sending all those follow-ups because I'm starting a new bootcamp, and then I'll kind of change that conversation. But the best advice I could give you guys from a social media perspective is don't be a performing monkey. Like provide value, show up and serve. Like, yeah, share your workouts and share the nutrition and all that, because that's a part of what we do. But you really like have fun with getting to know yourself through sharing it on social media. It's like, again, it's like this big self-discovery and self-growth journey. That's what this business is. And it's constantly evolving. And the more that you talk about like the little things that make you you, the more you're going to attract those people. And then you're going to find those people that you are excited to work with who will become your lifelong friends. How did you gain such a large following on social media? You guys, right now I have like 18,000. 2 weeks ago, I had 14,000. I did this, and of course, I mean, I've literally been on this account. I started this account January 2016 when I started coaching. So, you know, 5+ years, right? But Reels, a lot of momentum there right now. It's nothing you haven't heard before. I did with Sam, common theme here. We did this like 28-day Reel challenge. I actually have my content calendar right here. And I was so nervous to do it. I'm like, there's no way. Like, I'm going to, like, maybe, because Sam was like, I'm going to do 20 days of Reels. You want to do it with me? I'm like, yeah, but no. And I was like, maybe I'll do like 5 a week. You know, I was already like giving myself an out. But I was like, no, like, I want to commit. If she's going to do this, I'm going to do it too. So I spent Sundays planning everything out and like, you know, doing my little market research. Anyway, it's been really, I feel like doing Reels has brought, the joy back for me in social media. And I've been able to connect with a lot more people too. But if you're a newer coach, don't think you need to know like how to do stories and reels and posts and this and that. Like stay focused on just those initial wins. And if you have time to do a reel, great, you know? But you guys, like obviously it looks great to have a great big social media following, but quality over quantity always, 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 always. I don't do free groups. I have a few girls on my team who have. I have not done them yet. It's on my radar. Honestly, I don't have the bandwidth right now with my other job and everything else that I have going on. But it's something that I may explore in the future. All right, I know we're kind of at our hour. Any final questions or thoughts or anything?
Just wanted to say thanks for popping on tonight. I feel like this was really helpful for new coaches because a lot of the time they come in and they're like overwhelmed, but that was like super informative. So thank you.
Thanks for having me, guys. Glad it was helpful. And if there's any follow-up questions or anything else that I can do to help, I am here. Just holler at me.
See you guys.
All right, guys. Thank you.